Let's get started, everyone. But let's touch base with River State and the plans for the rerun election in that state. In about 48 hours from now, the people of River State will have the opportunity to again go back to the polls. What they were unable to complete the other time, they may be able to complete this time around in the legislative elections in the state. The elections have been hanging for several months. The forced conduct is over a year now, with the political parties trading blames, leaving the umpire and the police in the middle of the political game. Today in Port Harcourt, the umpire and the different security agencies, the police, the civil defense corps, met with politicians, and the police commissioner sounded a note of warning. Well, some that looked like a riot act, warning anyone planning to disturb the process.
The commission has fixed December 10, 2016 for the conclusion of the outstanding March 19 rerun election, and this date remains sacrosanct. What would the security agencies in the state to achieve free, fair and credible election in River State? We therefore urge the political parties and candidates to embrace peace and shun violence. We appeal that all the security agents that will be deployed for this exercise should support INEC towards a peaceful conclusion of the rerun election in this state, being optimistic that the December 10, 2016 rerun election will mark the end of SSN's rerun election in River State.
Wherever you are, by parading himself with an arm and trying to take that arm, we will not allow him. If he cock and press his hand, we'll cut off the hand. You are not going to have your way as usual, and we will not let you go. If there's any group here seated that I want to resort to self-help and want to enlist police from other places that have not been scheduled for this, and all other and other security agencies or civilian, and it's very easy to copy this dress. You can copy the brigade commander's dress. You can also take mine. You can also take one of these. If we get you, it is an open business. There is no secrecy.
Well, you can hear the police there, the police chief there, talking about how they will stop anyone who plans to get in the way and the plans of INEC. INEC, on one hand, says they are ready. But let's hold on to that. We will keep tabs on the Rivers rerun for you. China's television team will be on the ground, and we shall be monitoring and covering that elections for you. Well, let's move on to another issue that may interest you now. The year 2019 may be some 2 years away, but the frenzy towards that election cycle is now palpable. The sort of overtures we now see with politicians are clear indications that race couldn't be an easy one. We are seeing some very interesting scenarios playing out from the major political parties. The stories of a mega party has been on, going on for several weeks now. And some of the names bandied are reflections of what may play out in the end. A leader of the APC and former governor, Bola Ahmed Tinubu, said he is not planning to leave the APC. In some of his tweets, he stated that it is the party he has worked out to build. Well, if you look at what may be happening, for example, in the ruling APC, where a lot of people say leaders and supporters are unhappy with the sort of and the manner in which appointments have been made. Some people have even fast said that some leaders are bothered that some appointments are in the hands of the opposition party over a year since the last election. And some people have also said that President Buhari's wife, we've heard and we've seen when she spoke about how her husband has handled the politics in the APC, and how some people whom she said are not part of the initial planning of the party, and how she said she was not going to be part of the election hiring process in 2019 if the same status remain. Well, there are also fears of parties' chances in 2019 in the face of the nation's economic woes. These are some of the fears within the APC, and perhaps one of the reasons why a mega party idea is coming up. Let's flip the page now. Let's look at what has been happening in the PDP. Two groups have been laying claim to party leadership. The party has lost two crucial state elections since the losing grip of the center in 2015. The loss in Ondo State, the loss in Edo State. The party could hardly concentrate on opposition role because a lot of people have said the party that held sway over 16 years at the center will play a major opposition role. Well, it's not the major, it's not the only opposition party, but a lot of people have given it a major opposition party toga. But has it been able to live up to expectations? These are some of the crucial questions on the hanging over the PDP. There are also fears of 2019 agenda. Who is going to be the candidate of the party? Who is going to be pushed forward to lead the party? There is no president for the party at the moment. And so the leadership of the party has been a major problem. Governors are said to be leading the party, which has caused a lot of political commotion within the PDP. These are some of the overtures where we have seen. Listen to, look at it now. The talks about a new political platform, a mega party. That's what they call it. Some people, names have been mentioned in this. Some of them have denied it. Take a look at what Bola Tinubu, for example, has said. He said in one of his, in some of his tweets on Twitter, he said that he has built the APC. This is a party I labeled with others to build. We would not abandon it for another. Millions of Nigerians who voted are watching and praying. Series of tweets coming from Bola Tinubu on his Twitter handle showing that he may not be leaving the APC. But people have also warned me that when politicians talk at times, a day is too long in politics. Things change. This government, Bola Tinubu, has also said that APC is for the betterment of the people and the national purpose is bigger and more important than any individual desires. These are some of the thoughts of Bola Ahmed Tinubu, a leader of the APC, whom a lot of people say might be at the forefront of a mega party. He has denied it. But well, when you hear rumors like this within the political cycle, it may actually happen. Let's get a sense of what may happen in the coming days. Do we really need a new political platform? What exactly do we need to drive our democratic value and process? A former presidential aide to former president Goodluck Jonathan, a PR consultant and political analyst, Dr. Olusanya Awuson, joins us on the program now. Many thanks, Dr. Awuson, for coming on the program. A lot of overtures. This is not new, anyways. When we see parties in distress, when political gladiators are not really talking together and they're infighting in the political parties, especially the major political parties, we see this kind of overtures, we've seen this kind of realignment coming up and coming on. How, what do you make of it, and how do you, this come to you? Is this new to you, or is this a joke or something?
Well, it's not really new, but what we just have to first and foremost, agree that all this struggle, these struggles are not about Nigerian people. This struggle for power, the just mere struggle for power's sake, for enlightened self-interest of the political gladiators. It is not about Nigeria. It is not about development. It is not about good governance. Neither is it about delivering the dividend of democracy. It is just showing the character of the unstable character of Nigerian political system. You know, most of the part, the political, the operating system itself is lacking vision, rudderless. From the very beginning, political party is supposed to be an association of people of like minds who subscribe to certain methodology in social political engineering and who believe that they can build strategy all around it, all around that common belief, and then see to how life can become abundant for the people. But not, but in Nigeria case, it is not so. That is why it is easy for one to be able to go to bed as a member of PDP, and you tomorrow morning you wake up as a member of APC.
Well, this time around, some people may wake up as a member of a mega party that we do not know. But when we return from this break, because we'll go on a short break, and when we return, we'll be looking at what is going to be the interest of Nigerians. That's next on the program. Join us again.